Not long to go to our title fights, ladies and gentlemen. We've got three titles on the line. The Infliction middleweight title, the Infliction heavyweight title, and of course, the main event tonight is the WMC Australian Super Lightweight title. Right now though, fight number 10. All thanks to Fight HQ. Please welcome Tim Jolly.
I move like water, I go with the flow. I go back to old school, I go back to Rome. But this is not history, it's the start of the show. Never worry, that is the way that I roll. I'm a bad man, what is it? Let me say again. You can try copy like a slave to a trend. Nothing they can say and nothing they can do. It's no problem.
And his opponent fighting out of our red corner, this is Dave Broadhurst. Fight number 10, big thanks to the team at Fight HQ. This man in our blue corner, weighing in last night at 76.8 kilos, five fights for three victories. He trains at Yar Pit Muay Thai, and he fights out of the Sunshine Coast. This is Tim Jolly. His opponent in the red corner, also with a fight record of five fights and three victories, weighing in at 76.7 kilos. Fighting out of Honor Martial Arts Academy, please give it up for Dave Broadhurst.
Three by two, 77 kilos. For this one, fight number 10 on the card later tonight, Cassidy Haverfield, Sammy Gardner from WA, Isaac Papali'i and Jesse Astill will be one of those ones. You need to go to the toilet before that fight because I don't know. Just saying, Nick Atkins, before Isaac Papali'i and Jesse Astill, I would go to the toilet beforehand, sort out your cup of tea beforehand. Because you're not going to be returning, I think.
No.
To a later round sort of chess match between those two.
No, I don't think they'll want to go the distance. I think someone's going to get stopped.
Broadhurst charges forward. Dave Broadhurst, another name that's been on our cards a number of times.
Yep, he has. The former Bloodshed team, now on a martial arts. We always have a lot of support from them. We love those guys. And he has been on a few times.
I always thought Bloodshed was one of the best names for a gym. It's in a shed, but anyhow, that's just me. Tim Jolly from up my way, Yar Pit and Sunshine Coast. Obviously a couple of big gyms up that way. Closer heel lock, hip lock there. Strike after the referee has told them to cease fire. Lovely inside thigh shot from Broadhurst, and he goes outside on the next one.
Nice and relaxed, Tim. He's just bouncing away to the music, and he's got a bit of speed. So I think, Dave, get your hands up, mate. Get through this first round.
Tell you what, Tim Jolly looks very tall for 77 kilos, Nick. Very rangy.
He does, yeah.
And he's not a beanpole tall. He's got a bit on him.
No, he's thick, yeah. He's definitely, he'd be, I reckon, probably at least 86, 87 tonight.
Reminds me of a young Nick Atkins.
When I had abs.
You did. He did once. And vowed never to cut weight again.
Oh, no.
Knee work there. From the boy from the coast. That was a cracker, and so was that. When you can hear him from the other side of the auditorium, folks, you know they've got starch. But Broadhurst is one tough individual.
Yeah, big knees there from Tim. Beautiful knees.
Three of them.
Like Dave ate them.
And Dave Broadhurst, Nick, just decided, yeah, okay. Very willing first round there.
Yeah, certainly back and forth. I think Tim's got a beautiful style, and Dave just needs to get in there and make it a dogfight, I think.
Do you know what's funny? I've made a point of it, and I should get over it. We don't have headphones tonight, so I can't hear you as well. I thought you said Tim has a beautiful smile. And I was like, okay, not sure how that figures into this, but you're the former world champion and the boss.
He didn't smile at you.
No one ever smiles at me. Fight HQ, the sponsors of this one, fantastic. Organisation supplying you. Honestly, I'll do yourself a favour. I like to play a game. I like to get on Fight HQ and find something that I'm surprised they have in stock. Because there are that many bloody products. It's taking me longer and longer, but I'll get 12 pages deep on martial arts accessories and find some sort of thing that you have. Same day dispatch if you order before 2 o'clock, which means if you've got to order someone a birthday or otherwise present for next week and they're into martial arts, I've just done you a favour. Round two of this one, and I've got to say, Nick, you look at the two men and you think Dave Broadhurst, well, he's a brawler. He looks it. He's got that much ink on him and whatever else. And Tim Jolly just looks like a clean skin who's come out of law school.
Yeah, it's so different. Interesting, like I said, Tim's, I'm liking his style, but and also, you know, Bloodshed, Honor Martial Arts. They're tough. They bred them tough over there with Dwayne. They always have a crack and come to fight.
Absolutely. Alfie Smith in the corner over there. How long before we see him back in Infliction? It's a very noisy day at Broadhurst. I don't know if you're picking it up on the effects mics at all, but there's a lot of exhaling.
I think it's whistling through his beard.
Exactly. Exactly. Jolly marked up around his back, and that tend to be body kicks, I'd say, or even body rips. There's liver shots from Broadhurst, who's attacked that inside thigh quite effectively, but a beautiful knee again. Jolly's got some knees on him, Nick, I tell you.
No, he has. They're very dangerous. Dave's just got to keep throwing those combos and unsettle Tim, so he just not relaxed and stepping in with those knees.
I've always said there's nothing. There it is again. Nothing more dangerous than a tall man with timing on his knees. Absolutely crazy. The leverage we see there is just crazy.
Yeah, especially when you step into punch and they knee at the same time.
Combined.
That really, it really sucks. But
the broader
Dave's a bull. He's an absolute bull just walking forward.
Yeah, well, he's just walking over them and firing up top, and a big elbow there. And follows it up with the winner. And this is testing time here for Dave Broadhurst. But he does what Broadhurst does. He comes back firing with the leather, cops another knee and says, bugger it, let's go.
Another great fight.
I tell you what, folks. This is not a case of a bloke landing light shots and the other bloke walking through it. Dave Broadhurst, he's landing enough of his own with the gloves. He's walking through some artillery, Nick, I tell you.
Yeah. No, it's tough as nails. He's tough as nails. He should be proud of himself. Regardless what happens in the last round, the decision, he's an absolute beast.
He copped at one point here in the neutral corner, crossing elbow into step-up knee. Both landed flush.
didn't care.
Yep, and that crossing elbow towards the end of the round as well, that was flush too, and Dave didn't miss a beat. So as I said, they on a martial arts, they always come to fight. They're always super tough. I've been sparring there a few times, and when they spar on Saturday, sometimes it's pretty much like a fight anyway. They go pretty hard. It's beautiful to watch.
Also looking at it, I mean, real credit to Yarpit Muay Thai on the sunny coast. This kid, technically, he's, for want of a better word, his technique's been delicious. You know, it's been fantastic.
I love Tim. I love his style, Tim. I think it's really good, and I think he's probably, from here, I'd like to see him fight five rounds, actually, so we can start getting his rhythm and open up a bit more.
Here we
go. He's got the pace to go five rounds.
One round to go. Bex Tui alongside Nick Atkins. And it's Dave, the choo-choo train, Broadhurst. You can hear him there, the steam train. He is a steam train. And Tim Jolly. Big knee again from Jolly, high and low. He changes levels and then goes with the leather. Back to the knees, it's Jolly. Two and three. And Broadhurst again. Fair dinkum.
You know, Tim's just learning shots of will here, but as I said, Dave's taking
them.
We've
got a mouth guard on
back.
The floor. It's been, they're playing soccer with the mouth guard. I don't think you should be allowed to have a black mouth guard on a black canvas. That's unfair to the referee.
Testing the eyes of Marcus Burgess right there, but he's on point.
All under control. The thing I love about Marcus's style, Marcus lets people fight in the clinch if they're working. He's a big fan of the knee. He'd be loving what he's seen from Jolly, who backs off Broadhurst again, and that glancing knee across the body was a big one. And there's another one, but Broadhurst with the leather has been sublime. That knee was outrageous.
Yeah, beautiful knees by Tim.
Outrageous. You know, you can't do more than that if you're Tim Jolly, can you? You cannot. He put everything into it. He timed it well. It's solar plexus. And now it's Jolly who's tired, and he has to walk through Broadhurst for a change. Both of these men probably aching for the 10-second warning.
Good knees by Tim, too, in the clinch there.
His knees are ridiculous.
You don't see them seem a great deal of knee fighters these days that are kneeing is their main weapon, but you see Tim Jolly, his game plan is land the knees.
Absolutely wonderful. I mean, dozens of knees landed, and again, Dave Broadhurst, the steam train keeps coming.
Great fight.
A fight neither will forget, Nick. Years ago, our old mentor and trainer of sorts, Wayne Parr, used to talk about putting the belly button through the backbone when you knee. Tim Jolly did that, I'm going to say, two dozen times to Dave Broadhurst.
I was worried that Tim Jolly was going to hurt his knee in the end.
Yeah, exactly.
on Dave's abs, he was just a beast.
What a fight. Dave Broadhurst, you're a freak if you watch this. And, you know, it's one thing to call someone tough because sometimes that's just dumb luck. But he had plenty of his own Broadhurst. He let go with some fantastic work with the leather. He was kicking inside, outside very nicely. But Tim Jolly, just from that range, he's folding people at his size. He surely is.
No, he's got a bright... He looks pretty young too, so I think he's got a bright future. I'd be 6 in. As I said, watching someone who's their main weapons are knees, it's beautiful to watch. You can see how much power it drives.
Because everything else can develop too off that, like your knee. And that clinch is the hardest thing to do properly, isn't it?
Yeah, just get that long guard, wrap him in, pull him in for the clinch. It was just, it was really good to watch. But yeah, credit to Dave as well. Like I said, he didn't once look like he was actually in trouble.
Here's Dave Eller doing his best as an accountant, and he will have a victor for you in moments.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, one more big round of applause for these two. Some big hits, big Muay Thai action. That's what it's all about here at Infliction. But there's only going to be one winner. And after three rounds, ladies and gentlemen, the judges agree. Unanimous decision. To the blue corner, Tim Jolly.
I move like water. I go with the flow. I go back to old school. I go back to raw. But this is not history. Of the show. Never.
worry, that is the way that I roll. I'm a bad man. What is it? Let me say again. You can try and copy like a slave to a trend. Nothing they can say and nothing they can do. It's no problem for me.